All right, while market continues to remain sideways with a negative bias, triggered by what's happening in China and region also saw some jitters coming in. We have someone who's been operating a China fund for some time now. Radhika Gupta is joining us from Edelweiss Mutual Fund, out of the other great funds which they have. There is one very special fund which is called the Greater China Fund, which they've been running for some time now. The reason why we have Radhika, first of all, good afternoon, thanks so much for joining us. Now, out of this fund, you know, out of curiosity, we just wanted to have a chat with you on how you and your team are analyzing the developments triggering out of China. We'll not go into merits and demerits of it, but I want to understand from you, how are you analyzing the sudden shakeout outflows, and does it really present an opportunity to look at China? Because not just education, but it is bringing along, this correction is bringing along all the other non-education and technology companies also. Because you've been running this fund for some time, your understanding of it would be higher, I assume. So, first of all, how are you analyzing this big shakeout and today's commentary coming in the China State Daily that fundamentals will remain strong and they're trying to allay fears? What are your thoughts?
It's a pleasure talking to you and ET now. And I'll come to the fund specifically and education separately. But, you know, we run the Edelweiss Greater China Fund, and it's been a popular fund in partnership with JP Morgan Asset Management, who has a local team based in China. And a lot of the insights I'll share come from there. Now, obviously, over the last few days, you have seen significant news flow. But it is our belief that these pressures are transitory. In fact, you have had regulatory overhang in China, not just in technology, but also at some point in sectors like pharma. We do believe that the regulatory overhang doesn't impact the long-term corporate strengths, the culture of innovation, the desire for entrepreneurship that has done well. I think when people are talking about Chinese regulators, they are taking a one-size-fits-universal approach to the whole China story. It is not, in our view, a belief that China and their regulators just want to indiscriminately destroy the tech industry that has been built up. In fact, given what is happening in US, China and all that rivalry, it would hardly be in their interest to do so. So I think that's the first comment. The moves are more in line with building a more resilient and level playing field, which allows competition to thrive. So you're not dismantling companies. You just want to make sure that the next cohort also has some space to flourish. So one, I think we think that the move is less drastic than people think it is. And it's also not out of line with what is happening in the West. It's happened in China later. But a level playing field is not out of line with what is happening in the West. I'll come to EduTech separately, because that is a separate issue altogether. But we think broadly what China is trying to curb is inappropriate use of market power, certain exploitation areas, any kind of monopolistic behavior, data security issues, etc. And yes, and we can come to this also, we do believe that in some places this will open up valuation opportunities in specific companies that we can talk about.
Okay, so Radhika, just wanted to understand from you that I see the constituents of your Greater China Fund have got some of the best names like semiconductor companies. Actually, they are in a very boom period right now because of the shortages. Insurance companies, biologics, healthcare. It's a great fund, a regional fund. Do you think that because the entire region is coming under pressure because of what's happening, and maybe some funds are coming out of the region because they have big tilt toward China, it's a great opportunity to look at the merits of a fund such as the Greater China Fund?
We do think so. And in fact, over the last 3 days of correction, and while, you know, 10% is not a material correction in equities, the interest we've got is largely an adding. I will make a few comments. One, we run our diversified fund, Ajay. So technology is not the only theme that we play in the fund. And as you correctly said, even within technology, there are themes, you know, that are very, very positive. So semiconductors, for instance, software, are currently beneficiaries of import substitution. Financials, consumption, that story doesn't change. So we run tech, we run health, we run consumption. And that continues to be there. We do not, by the way, have any exposure in this fund to any kind of education technology company. We believe that that space and the regulatory action in that space is completely different, because you're trying to protect education pricing in China. So that's a completely different space. We don't have exposure to that. But we fundamentally believe that if you look at companies like Meituan or Alibaba, the fundamentals of those companies have not changed, but they're available at valuations that are back to 3-year lows actually now, which is posing an opportunity for investors interested in China. And quite frankly, if you're an emerging markets investor today, you already have India allocation. China is the other major market that you have to have allocation to.
And Radhika, before we let you go, a quick word on the way Indian markets are in the middle of a very nice rally which is playing out. In fact, just moments back, our financial market regulator, SEBI chairman, also did comment on China. In fact, also saying that there is no euphoria in the market. Everything is, you know, as per routine stuff. It does allay a lot of fears, because there is a section of the market which believe that certain pockets of the market are getting euphoric. What are your thoughts on the kind of valuation, especially in broader markets, versus the growth and earnings quality which are being reported?
So I think, look, there are various comments being made on the market, and I think a lot of the valuation commentary has also been made on the primary market. While markets are definitely not cheap, I think the last two quarters of earnings in our view have actually shown reasonable positivity. And I think the primary market is booming. You know, Ajay, we also run a IPO-focused fund in the domestic market. I think what is giving us a lot of optimism is also the fact that a lot of new business models are coming to market and are also being accepted extremely well. Ultimately, the fundamentals of companies will start playing, will play out, whether it is in India or China. But I think the primary market actually gives us a lot of optimism in India.
Radhika, always wonderful to be chatting with you. Thanks so much for your time today as well. That was Radhika Gupta of Edelweiss Mutual Fund talking about what their view on this China-related sell-off or weakness in Asia is, because they do study that region very closely. Of course, they are running a Greater China Fund, which have got regional large-cap companies. And in fact, the entire space, apart from edutech, is also coming down. So does it present a good opportunity? One section of the market believes that long-term bulls for Asia led by China, it's a great opportunity for looking at companies in healthcare space, Asian companies in